All right, guys, good afternoon. Little project here. That's a 953. I hauled in 6 loads of fill yesterday. And now what I got to do is go in and make a cut here. These stakes, the stakes with the flags are going to be about 2.5 foot deep. So basically, I'm going to go in and cut this out. And if I got anything good that's usable for fill for the pad, I'll bring it out, lay it in here. If not, I'm gonna have to haul some more. I'm gonna have to haul some more fill dirt. So, but anyway, I'm gonna set you up here and we'll kind of probably just do a time lapse on this. Shouldn't take all that long to do. We're gonna have to dig out here too, because he wants to be able to come in. He's going to put railroad ties or something up there to kind of use as a retaining wall. But he wants to be able to come in this direction. He has a lean-to behind, and then be able to go out or vice versa there. So, anywho, we're just going to start digging here and going to start stacking probably over there where the loader's at. Some of that dirt I'll be able to use to for the slopes and everything on the backside. But anyway, we got to get him up and going. So I'll set you up and we'll watch this real quick. Alrighty guys, good morning. This is a pad that I'm building, this barn shop pad. Brought a couple more loads of material I'm gonna spread out here real quick. You can see our marks. That's our outside of our building. All that up there is the grade. I just gotta raise this up here. So anyway, I'm gonna take real quick with Bobcat if it'll quit on me. When I was digging that storm shelter out and everything a week or so ago, I was backing up and all of a sudden, boom, the brakes locked, had no function at all. Loader function, travel function, I looked up and there was a code. And I didn't take a picture of the code or write the code down. But anyway, I shut it off, fired it back up, took right off, didn't do it again. This morning, I got in it to bring it out here, fired it up, and fired right up. However, the gauges weren't working on the display. None of the gauges were working. So I shut it off, fired it back up, and they started working. So anyway, I'm thinking I probably got an ECM issue or something. The ECM's fixing to go out or whatever other control module's in there for that. So yay, more money. But anyway, we're gonna run it and see what happens. I guess if it quits, then we'll know what it is. But anyway, we'll set you up, spread these out real quick, and then I'll have to go get some more. I'm gonna at least two more, probably more than that, but we'll see. gonna take some of this stuff here in front of us, and I'm gonna take and fill in some of the edges of the pad. We're overbuilt 3 foot around the entire dimension, so we got plenty of room, and that and the building could be slid back to the north, which is where the cut is. But anyway, I'm just gonna, instead of running and getting another load of dirt, I've about got all the good clay out of there I can get. So we've got dirt here, the pad's built, the pad's compacted. We're just gonna use this to kind of dress it up a little bit, fill in some, fill in kind of the perimeter there where it was just a little bit short. No load bearing or anything on it. It's a lean-to anyway. So anyway, we're just gonna do that, get rid of some of the dirt we have here. Thank you. get them. I may try to tomorrow repack those cylinders. Ugly, but it's gonna be kind of ugly. them, it does, you can tell there's a difference. Guys, well, I'm pretty well done. Not perfect, but not too bad. It'll work. It'll work. Anyway, not much filming on this one. Like I said, I was trying to hump it and get this done. I think I'm going to work on that. Work on the Bobcat tomorrow. See if I can't get those two cylinders repacked. And then I may jump into pulling connections or, electrical connections in here and see if I can find out what's going on. It hadn't done anything today other than this morning. So I've worked its butt off. It's been running pretty warm, but it's 100 and, like I said, it was going to be a 104, 105 heat index today. So anyway, all right, guys, I'm out of here on this one. Don't forget to like and subscribe, leave comments, ring that notification bell, and that way you know when I post new videos. Follow me on Instagram, DirtDaddy953, and there'll be some pictures on there. So anyway, guys, as always, I appreciate you. We'll see you on the next one.